The Benue Caucus recalls that when Chief Lam Adesina was governor of Oyo State, President Muhammadu Buhari, then a private citizen, reportedly visited in Ibadan, perhaps as grand patron of Mieti Allah, umbrella organization of cattle rearers in Nigeria, to complain to the governor that his people, the Fulani herdsmen, were being attacked by indigenous farmers. Is that why the herdsmen are now taking advantage of his position as president to wreak havoc on our people? We are saying this invasion must stop, for we will no longer tolerate the violation of the integrity of our people. We want Mr. President to act like the soldier that he is now. You are all aware that Benue State is the food basket of the nation. But it is disturbing that every planting season is heralded by serial attacks by these Fulani herdsmen. They also return during the harvesting season. Where are the herdsmen getting the sophisticated ammunition from? Why is it taking government so long to smoke out those behind this genocide? Since the beginning of this carnage, how many of these herdsmen have been arrested? We can no longer fold our arms while our people are being killed like chickens by jihadists who camouflage as herdsmen. We want to warn and make it crystal clear that the hospitality and accommodating nature of Benue people must not be abused any longer. The fact that we are accommodating does not mean we are weak. Are we not entitled to be protected by the Nigerian state as the Constitution stipulates? Or are we being told by this obvious neglect that we are on our own and we shall only survive if we organize our own protection from these rampaging marauders? Our people are not wild animals to be hounded at will. Gentlemen, it is a fact that cattle rearing is an integral part of the economic mainstay of some northerners and have no doubt contributed to a sustained production and sales of cow meat in markets across the country. But the recent activities of Fulani cattle rearers in Benue State are threatening the life and existence of our peace-loving people, especially in the rural areas. Benue State is known as the food basket of the nation. But how can that be when there appears to be a calculated agenda to kill, maim, and displace the people in large numbers? We want to bring to the notice of Mr. President, the federal government, and indeed the whole world that several local government areas in Benue State, including Buruku, Guma, Gwe West, Logo, Kwande, Taka, Gwe West, Makudi, Agatu, and Katsinala have been under perennial heavy attacks from the Fulani herdsmen since 2013. The incessant attacks by these Fulani herdsmen have resulted in the deaths of thousands of Benue people. Since the beginning of this year, not less than 1,000 people have been killed and property worth millions of naira destroyed by these ravaging Fulani herdsmen. It is despicable and unacceptable that despite the outcry that trailed the killings and sacking of Agatu communities by the Fulani militia, the marauders have continued unabated, laying siege on other local governments and killing more people. The visit of the Inspector General of Police, Mr. Solomon Arase, and his unsympathetic statement that the number of those killed was blown out of proportion expectedly encouraged the herdsmen who have intensified their killing bazaar in the state. These herdsmen have, in the last few weeks, sacked 100 villages in Logo, Buruku, Kwande, Makudi, Gwe West, Taka, Guma, and Katsinala, and Katsinala local government areas, killing over 300 people and destroying hundreds of homes. These herdsmen do not spare anyone. The governor, Dr. Samuel Otom himself, has lost over 100 hectares of paddy farm to the attackers since coming into office. A few days ago, some policemen were also reportedly hacked to death in the state by these marauders. This is in spite of the fact that Governor Otom, on taking over last year, had gone to great lengths to negotiate peace moves with the herdsmen. But apparently, the more the herdsmen are at peace, the more flagrant and audacious they carry on with their activities. There is a grave danger ahead if the federal government continue to shy away from taking pragmatic actions to end this carnage and genocide against our people. If the federal government fails to end this regime of impunity and senseless killing, we will not hesitate to mobilize our people and defend ourselves in whatever way we can. We can no longer continue to remain docile and sedate while the Fulani herdsmen desecrate our land, kill our men, women, children, rape women, destroy our farms, and raise our houses. this is the time for the Benue people, especially the youth, to stand up and defend their state. These killings, kidnappings, raping by herdsmen must stop. It is often said that when violence confronts violence, peace will reign. So if the federal government delays in nipping these senseless killings in the bud, we will confront our adversaries and attackers frontally. We will urge the security agencies to stop the attacks, killings, and wanton destruction of property by the Fulani militia. They should arrest, disarm, prosecute, and jail the foot soldiers and their sponsors. We also call on the Nigerian Immigration Service to be alive to its responsibilities in identifying and expelling foreign nationals who constitute security risks to the country. Thank you, gentlemen. That is the end of it. Yeah. So this document, like I said, is made by all of the 11 members. I forgot to add our Togbo local government too is part of those local governments that have been attacked. That is the brief address that we have to give.
Questions, gentlemen of the press, the usual tradition, your name and the organization you represent. Please.
The brief. Questions.
Nation where violence meets violence, peace will reign. Okay, that's one. Then secondly, you said that these people don't know where they get sophisticated weapons, and that if the FG does not do anything about it, many people will rise up and defend themselves. Now, some people might misconstrue this as a call to war, particularly people that are the victims in this case. Don't you think, I'm just asking, don't you think that those words are rather strong in a situation where we have Masuk, we have Okwaram, we have all sorts of things happening right now? That's just my, and how do you intend to defend yourself, sir?
If you look at the totality of what we have said, we have consistently been asking on the federal government to protect us. But we cannot wait to be chased out of, chased off the face of the earth. I mean, as a last resort, what do you expect us to do? We are not going back home to arm the people to fight. What we are saying is that we should be protected. But in the event that we are not being protected, I think it's a natural human thing that you need to defend yourself. That is as a last resort. I don't think it is beyond the federal government to defend the people, to protect the people of Benue State. But like I said, my colleagues can have a word or two.
Yeah. For that question, Benue State has been under sustained attacks by Fulani herdsmen since 2013. The federal government has not arrested one person since then. You will recall that prior to the elections of 2015, our communities were sacked. Some of our people couldn't even go back to register or vote in the election. We think that there's a grand plan to depopulate the people of Benue State and deny them access to even elections and farming, which is the mainstay of the economy of Benue State. Our people have not been farming. When he said, he made mention of a situation where when we're cultivating, we'll be attacked. When we're harvesting, we'll be attacked. What do you expect us to do? We have no any other option than to just defend ourselves. And I think that is the reason why he said, in defending ourselves, some people may misconstrue that to say that we're fighting. Of course, we need to defend ourselves. Thank you very much.
Your question.
Please, going forward, what would be your suggestion to the federal government? What would you suggest to the federal government?
Thank you. Thank you. To Agatu last week, visited almost all the destroyed community. I went with the former Senate President, my colleague, Sam Sinoku, and former ministers who were there. I think by now the security, the military should be there. Very scanty of them are there, but they are not doing anything. The worst of it all, as you go, Fulanis and their cattle are still there. Chase away these people, and they have come to take control of that. And I think the federal government have immediate solution to that. Take the military people, chase. Once the community, the residents are not there, the herdsmen also, and their cattle should also be left there. And I think the second solution to it is, even if you go to a developed country, you don't see herdsmen moving up and down. If that is a business, we are farmers and that is our own business too. Got a land, and then you have a ranch for this cattle, and they will be restrained. A situation that you go and they are roaming everywhere, eating, going into farms, destroying things, I think it's not one of our colleagues here has a bill on that too, and very soon at the floor of the House, it will be presented, and I think we'll do justice to it. It has passed the first reading for second reading now, and I think the best approach for it is for them to be constrained. Get a land and then have a cattle ranch. As much as you take that to be business, others, farming is their business.
Just in addition, gentlemen of the press, just a point of emphasis. Because the Benue people have no 1 inch of their land to allow herdsmen to come and destroy, we strongly suggest to the federal government, put your cows in ranches. This is 21st century, for God's sake. We are not ready. The Tiv people, the Idoma people are not ready to concede 1 inch of their land for people to come and take and graze. We are not ready to do that. And we're sending this message very, very strongly and very clearly. We won't do it. We are speaking on behalf of the millions of Benue people that are standing behind us.
I've heard you speak on government coming to defend your community, but I've not heard anything on the displaced people, the wounded, the raped women. Are you doing or seeking for any international assistance concerning that?
I will make a contribution while my other colleagues will contribute to answer the question. Now, as members, we are collectively and individually looking at immediate assistance that we can provide to our people. But we're also using this medium. These are not only in Boko Haram ravaged areas. This Honorable 8th Assembly has passed an amendment to a resolution which was unanimously adopted that even those who are victims of these attacks should be considered as IDPs. But up till now, the federal government has not brought up any intervention program for these communities. So this is one of the issues that we want to mention very categorically that we have a particular concern about. The House, in its own effort, is trying to intervene also in this area. But we would like the federal government to take very particular focus on the plight of the IDPs from this crisis as well. Thank you.
It's heard there is this notice development initiative. And I think what is good for the gender is also good. If you go to Agatu, Aguma, and Logo, a part of Ogo, believe you me, we begin to wait for this people. Like I told you, I went to Agatu. I don't even see how that place. No, I don't even see how those people can go back to their villages again. So federal government, as a matter of urgency, must also put an initiative of seeing how they can bring that place alive. The whole schools there are destroyed. No hospitals, nothing for the children. There is an ID camp in Bokona, one in Adoka, and also part of in Utupo. I am just talking about the recent one. When you go to Gumalugo and the rest, you will begin to pity those people. There is victim support fund, and a lot of money has been sunk there. What are the federal government doing with it? They should also come out and begin to assist those people.
The FRC, I think that's a very good question, because I've always said that Boko Haram and the Fulani herdsmen attack is almost the same. Those are people that live in the bush. And you don't know, because what you saw in Agadu and all those areas that I mentioned to you is a coordinated attack. A could have even said that there was no, it was a plan issue, because for people to remain in their community and you come and send them away from community as a visitor, as a stranger, you will believe there is a coordinated attack. And if any money is made to rebuild the Northeast, I'm calling the federal government, all of us here, that the federal government should make that money available to go and rebuild those areas in Benue State as a matter of urgency and as a matter of fact, to allow those people to return back to their community. Because they are all farmers. And at the worst of the matter was that you will see that the Fulani people, those are the farmers, the Fulani people, after destroying the houses, raising everything down, they go back to the farm produce and now destroy the farm produce. So how will they live on earth again? So we are calling on the federal government, the intervention fund made to rebuild the Northeast should be made available to go and rebuild all this part of Benue State. Thank you.
Today is genocide against the people of Benue State. Genocide. Whoever denies that this is not genocide does not know the meaning of that word. Yesterday I watched on CNN where the American government qualified what ISIS did to the Yazidis. And what happened to the Yazidis? The Yazidis were displaced from their homes into the mountains where they were rescued. And some of their women raped and taken captive. Some of them killed. Some of them were sold into slavery. That's what is happening in our communities in Benue State today. Fulani herdsmen come into our communities, rape our women, kill our men and children. In fact, the next time we are going to have this press conference, we will come here with projectors and show you the level of destruction in our various communities and the children that were killed in our communities. If that is not pogrom, if that is not genocide, then the world doesn't exist. And the world must take care of this. The world must know what's happening in Benue State. That is the reason why we're speaking out today. We are defenseless. We have nothing to do. We are relying on government for the past 5 years and they have not come. Thank you very much.
What is the first and foremost was to disarm the youth. The what should now be very famous. The amnesty program for those who will come for those who will after that the government will against them. So the people of Benue State are not harming themselves for anything. But we are concerned that while we have decided to live peacefully with our neighbors, we have decided to live peacefully with those Fulani herdsmen who, by the way, over time we have lived together. Suddenly, this is happening. That's why you can't avoid the conclusion that there's an agenda somewhere, because we have lived with these people for over centuries. Our backs are against the wall, and I think the only solution is for the federal government to step in. We don't want to be pushed to a situation where we have to fight for our survival. That should be emphasized.
Most of Benue have issued statements challenging the state government. So as this caucus make effort to reach out to the state government, the state governor who is the chief security of the state on this issue, and those who visited individually, did they make efforts to reach out to the governor? And what was his response? Thank you.
Explain about the attacks